Hello guys, this is Mauro from BrimFotech.com, and in this video I want to show you a quick tour of the Windows 10 build 10041, and there is quite a few features in this new build, so let's right dive into them. Okay, the first thing you're going to notice is now we have a new lock screen. The new lock screen has for each profile has a circular image profile, so that's a nice touch. We also have the switch user at the bottom. And if we have more user accounts, we can click there to switch to a different user. So I'm going to log into my account. And now we have, this is the updated desktop. It looks identical to the previous preview that Microsoft released. That was the 9926. One thing you'll notice is that the contextual menu are much better integrated on this build. Even if I use touch, you'll see that now we got each option more spaced out, so you can actually navigate the settings with your fingers. This will happen in the test bar, but Microsoft hasn't updated the ones on the actual desktop. And another cosmetic change is, as you can see now, the previews for each app and has been refined, and now you can see now that we have, like before, we had the X right there to close the app if you want to, but it has like a better look than before. It's not transparent or anything. And another thing that Microsoft has added to this build is new improvements to the task view or virtual desktops. Now we have the new desktop to the button right on the bottom right corner, and we can click and add as many desktops as we want. Each desktop now has a name, or I mean has a, it's enumerated, so now each desktop has a number, so it's easier to identify which desktop you're using and the location on the taskbar. So that's really nice. Another thing that Microsoft added and this to the task view is now you can finally drag apps and move it to the desktop you want, and you can do it with all the with any app you want. Now here's the thing, you won't be able to move the app from one desktop to another if you grab the frame of the app, like you can see, like I can't move it. So you have to actually click and press the actual app and then move it to the desktop, which I think it's not the best way because people can get confused, but that's how Microsoft is doing it. Might get updated in future updates, but that's how it also, you can see the user interface has been updated, and it looks it looks nicer and more complete from previous versions. Also, you will notice that the apps that you're running on one desktop will not show up in another desktop. So you can see right now it doesn't show that I don't have any app. Like if I open File Explorer, it will open a new instance, and even for Internet Explorer. But this only happens with the specific apps or locations. Like if I try to open an app, it won't open a new instance. For example, I have opened the store, and I want to open it in a different desktop. It will just move the desktop. It moved me to the desktop where that app is open. So that's something to keep in mind while using the new updated task view. You can change the settings if you want to see the all the apps that are running on the desktop and all the desktops. You can actually go to the settings page, go to system and multitasking, and here it says additional desktops. Just click all desktops, and then now you can see all the running apps in all the desktops. But I like to have that separated, so that's the option I like. So that's the quick view for the task view, and now let's move to the start screen. I mean to the start menu. As you can see now, the start button has a smaller icon. I don't know what is that, but Microsoft it's working on the whole start menu, so that's a lot of things are going to be changing. It's not a permanent thing that we're seeing right now. So now we can see that we finally have a transparent background for the start menu, and we have a new button to expand and restore the start menu. We also have now we have the File Explorer, Documents, and Settings attached to the start menu. They don't have the an icon to identify what they are, just the names, and that's like a sign that these are links that are just going to stay there. Maybe there is a way to change them out, but that's how they're going to stay. Also, Microsoft has updated the all apps. Now you can see the new menu icon, and now one thing we can do is drag an app and actually pin it to the start screen like section on the start menu. And now it's much easier to rename a group. I'm just going to put group on it, and now we have name our group on the start menu, which was a little bit more difficult in previous versions. Also, in build 10041 on all apps, now we have folders that indicate with the down arrow that indicates that there are more options, and we can just click and access to the different tools depending on the application and what we have installed. And it's really nice that we have that change, so we have a distinction and we can quickly see with the arrow that it is an option that has more tools or more applications that is grouped differently on the all apps. Also, in this build, we have the power button. Now we can send the computer to sleep right from the power menu. On the desktop, we can also see that, for example, File Explorer, now icons has been updated. Now we have a flash like icon for the quick access. And if we go to this PC, we can see the new icons on the device and drives, and all around we can see new updated icons on the operating system. We can actually see that we have the recycle bin, which many people don't like. I think it's pretty basic, and I think Microsoft have to pay more attention or work more on the icons that are going to be released. I'm not really pleased with all the icons that I see right now, but that's just a personal opinion, so don't take my word for it. Another thing that has changed on build 10041 is there is a new network flyout menu that will list all the networks that you're connected to, or if you have a wireless connection, it will list all the access points that you can connect to. And we have this little network settings that will actually open the networks and internet settings and the actual settings apps, so you can change all your network settings and more. And you can actually pin, as you can see the pin right here, you can pin that to the start menu, I think. Yes, you see right here appears the Ethernet appears right there, so you can just pin that and you can just click and pin, which is nice, an addition if you just want to keep that. I don't know why it's not coming out, but this build is pretty buggy, so there's a lot of things that are not working really, really well. So, but you're supposed to unpin it, and you're supposed to disappear from the start menu. Now that we are here on the settings, I just want to show you that Microsoft has been tweaking and updating the settings apps, which we know now that Microsoft is it's building to actually replace the control panel. So on a near future or in a distant future, we know the control panel will no longer exist on Windows, on Windows 10 at least. So what's new on the settings? So now we have, I'm just gonna, pretty much all the settings are the same as you've seen in 9926 build of Windows 10, but there is a few changes. For example, the Microsoft updating throughout the operating system, now they use the pill switch. I call it the pill switch, but they have different name for it. And you can see now the streamline, and now it looks more modern, and it has a better look each button and each element on the settings for all the apps and throughout the operating system that uses a modern UI. We have new settings. This apps and features is new, and now we can easily see which apps are installed in the operating system, and we can just click uninstall really easily. We can sort these the apps by sign, name, install date, and we can list the apps depending on the storage where they are installed. And we had a search box where we can look for apps, specific apps, and uninstall them and see how much space they're using on the on our system. So the optional features have been moved to this section as well, but there's not a lot of things that we can do more than adding more more languages to the operating system. One thing that I want to show you here is that, not specifically to speech, but throughout the settings, is that now we have a new related settings section that will give us a related setting that we can configure. If you're configuring like a specific option, it will give you related settings that you can further configure. Now these links, they can go to another part on the settings apps, but it also can also open settings on the control panel. Let me see if I can find one. You see it right here. I click the related settings on, and it says like action center notifications. I click that and immediately open the control panel settings for that specific configuration. Another thing, so let me see, storage sense, that hasn't changed much. And multitasking has been changed, and used to be called windowing, but here's where you go. We talked about this before. You can, these are the settings for the virtual desktop or task view, and you can change some of the settings. Now in maps, we have the options for meter connections, so you can turn on and off, so you can control not to make downloads of maps when you're in a limited cap connection to the internet. Another thing that's new to the system settings is a Windows Defender. Now we have Windows Defender, the free antivirus for Windows. We have most of the options right into the built-in into the settings apps. We can view the info of the version that you're running. You can exclude files and folders, and have like you can turn it on and off, the real protection, and a few other settings. Share, that's been there already, and tablet mode also has been updated, and now we have options to let Windows 10 know when is it that we want to be prompt to use the tablet mode. The talking about tablet mode, the notification center has a little bit been updated. It's just some shadows and cosmetic, but nothing has been changed much since build 9926. We have the same options, and we can even still use the tablet mode, and we can get to the to apps and places. And all right, so one thing I did here wrong is just jumped into the notifications when I was talking about the settings app. So let me just show you really quick things that they have changed. The device hasn't changed much. And network and internet, now we have a fewer options, but in each option we have new related settings, which has more settings that you can configure. Internet, like you see the wireless doesn't appear here, but that's because I'm running a virtual machine that doesn't connect wirelessly to the internet. Personalization is still the same. User and account, that still is the same. Setting options is still the same. Workplace stay the same. Settings stay the same. So other users stay the same. Times and languages also hasn't received any updates. Easy access either. You have closed captioning, but that was already built in 9926. Privacy, we do have a few new sections that we have contact that you can configure and let other apps as your contacts, calendar, and messaging. Messaging is also another option that will let you manage the permission to choose the apps that can read and send messages. And all right, so oh, and really important setting that has been updated on build 10041 is an update and recovery. And that option goes on Windows Update. If you go to the advanced options, you can now choose how you download updates, and that will take you to a new section. This actually allows us to get more to get the updates, not just from the from Microsoft servers, but from other PCs on your local network or local network on the internet. This will help to offload work from Microsoft servers and will help the users to get updates more quickly, because they're going to come from different computers. This you can download the updates for the OS and applications. Of course, the apps that we're talking about, those are the apps that come from the Windows Store. And of course, the first thing that comes to mind is what's going to happen with security. So we can only assume that Microsoft knows about what's going, you know, that it's that it could be some problem with security and privacy concerns. So we're pretty sure we're going to hear from the company telling us how this is going to make it better, and it's now going to be a door, like a back door for hackers or someone else to take over a computer or get infected from other computers. And let me show you really quick. Oh, now if you go, I'm not going to go there, but if you in the advanced setup, when you go to recovery, click restart and you will get the options to roll back to the previous build of Windows 10. So that's pretty much what's new on the settings. And now let's see what else we have to talk. All right, so Microsoft have also updated the UI and the Windows feedback, so now it's a lot better to send feedback to Microsoft and, you know, check other feedbacks that users are submitting to them. So you can help Microsoft to make Windows better by coming to here and help. Also, the Inside the Hub app has been updated, and now you can track your progress. And I've been doing a lot, but this doesn't reflect of all the stuff that I've been doing. But, you know, you can see that every time you do something, it will appear here in your activity feed, and you can, you know, you can see your progress, like helping Microsoft get Windows better. All right, so what else? As additional settings included on Windows 10 build 10041, it said Cortana now works on China, the UK, France, Italy, Germany, and Spain. That is in addition to United States and Canada. Another chance that you're going to see is that now you can print PDF natively on Windows 10. And now you can install apps from and move apps to an SD card, something that we knew was going to happen, but that wasn't possible until this bill. And also, like, if you make the taskbar really small, you can still see the time. As you can see, we've seen this in a bill 10036, but now the notification button icon has the same hover as the system tray icons, so now it's more blended in. So the text on canvas has been improved, so it's easier to use digital ink to write on Windows 10. So I think that we cover all the new changes, or at least the major changes on Windows 10 build 10041. And we expect more changes coming soon. This was released in the fast ring of updates, so it's buggy, and there is few workarounds to get it working. This is not a build that you should be using as your primary operating system. And we know by now that Windows 10 will be released on sometime in the summer, and it will be available in 190 countries and on 111 languages. So this was a quick tour and a little more information of what you needed to know for Windows 10 build 10041. I hope this video was informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.